Hello students, I am Ishan Trivedi. Welcome you in the video lecture series. Here, in today's session, I am going to cover the example of linear regression analysis on zonal basis. Earlier, I taught you regarding the multiple linear regression analysis where we understood the set of equations. Before that session, I taught you regarding the simple linear regression analysis on set of examples. Now, in this session also, I am going to teach you about the simple linear regression analysis, but here the context will be different. So let us have a problem statement first. The following data is calculated for a town. Develop a linear regression model for the trips generated for a zone. If the population in the particular zone increases to 86,500, then predict the expected trip generation from that zone. Here, you have given the number of zone and that is 7 in number. Here, the dependent variable is y and that is the total generated trips in 1000. Whereas, the population in that zone is the independent variable. Here, this is also given in thousands. So, here, whatever the linear relationship I will develop, I will put the number of population that future has forecasted and that increase of 86,500, I will put this value in the equation and I will compute the total number of expected trips which are going to generate in future. So, first of all, we will understand which are our dependent and independent variable and the number of zone and the basic equation. So here, the dependent variable, again I am telling you, that is the total number of trip that generated in that particular zone, that is denoted by y. Remember this thing. Second is the independent variable, that is x, and that denotes the population in particular zone. Here the number of zones are 7, so it is denoted by 7. And we have this general simple linear regression analysis equation, that is y is equal to a plus bx, where a denotes the additive constant, whereas b denotes the multiplying constant. So first, let us compute those values which I require for the finding the value of a and b, and validating those values and the equation with r value, that is our coefficient of correlation. And by validating, I will compute whether the model is appropriate or not, and based on that I will compute the final answer. So first is what I have. I have the number of zones, I have the population in each zone, that denotes the independent variable, that is x. Then there is total number of trips, that is y, that is our dependent variable, that denotes by y, and we have set of data. Now what do we require? We require xy, x square and y square data. So here, to finding out the xy value, what I am going to do, I will just multiply the 25 and 15 and I will get the answer. Similarly for x square value, what I will do, I will do the 25 value and I will just make a square value of this 25 value, and therefore y square, I will just compute the 15 square. Similarly, I will do it for the consecutive zone of 2, 3, 4, 5 up to 7 zone, and ultimately I will find out the summation of all these values. So first I will compute the xy, x square and y square value for each zone, and these are the answers. Now after computing these values, I will make the summation of all these values including of xy, x square and y square value. Don't forget to take the count of zones. Here n represent the number of surveys or zones which we have calculated in our survey profile, and that is 7. So here in zone, you do not make the summation of all those 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 value. You have to just write down the numbers, not the summation of all those things. So here the sigma n, the number of samples are 7. Sigma x is 154. Then sigma y, that is 99, sigma xy, that is 2200, 23, Then sigma x square is 3500 and sigma y square it is 1427. Now taking these values for our reference so that we can compute those equation and the correlation coefficient. So first we will find out the x bar and y bar value which are required for finding the additive constant, and later we will find out the b value. So first I will compute the x bar value, that is sigma x upon n, where sigma x is given in the table, that is 154, and the n is 7, and that gives me the answer 22. For y bar, I will compute sigma y upon n, that is 99 upon 7, I will get the answer 14.40. Now I will compute the multiplying constant, that is b value. For b, we have the equation n sigma xi yi minus sigma xi into sigma yi upon n sigma x square minus sigma xi whole raised to square. Now putting these values, we have the n value, that is 7, sigma xi yi value is 2223. Then minus we have the value of sigma x, that is 154, into sigma y value 99 upon what we have, sigma x square value. So 7 into x square value is 3500 value, minus here what we have to put, sigma x, that is 154 and its square, and ultimately by computing and by simplifying I'll get the answer b value is 0.4. Now I will find out the additive constant, and for that the equation is a is equal to y bar minus b into x bar. By putting those derived value, I will find out the answer, and that is 5.34. So by computing these values, my equation is in the form of y is equal to a plus bx, that is my trip generating equation. And if I put the value of a and b, then it is y is equal to 5.34 plus 0.40 into x. That is my trip generating equation. Now for validating this equation, I will find out the coefficient of correlation, that is r value. By finding this r value, whether my model or you can say the relationship between the total trips and the population in zone are correlated strongly or not, that I am going to know. For this thing, now what should I do? I have to put those desired values in this equation here again. N sigma xi yi minus sigma xi into sigma yi upon n sigma xi square minus sigma xi whole raised to square into n sigma yi square minus sigma yi whole square. Now in this, what I'm going to do here, I will put those values, that here n is equal to 7, sigma xi yi value is 2223. Then minus sigma xi value is 154 and sigma yi value is 99 upon under root into 7 into what I have. I have the value of sigma xi square, that is 3500 minus 154 square into again 7 into sigma y square, that is 1427 minus 99 square. By computing and simplifying, I'll get the answer, and that is 0.82, which is more than 0.8. And here I can simply say that there is a strong relationship between these two independent and dependent variable. Now by computing the correlationship between these two variables, now I will compute the futuristic trips in this zone by futuristic population. And what we have the population data, that is in future the population of zone will be 86,500. So here in this I will take x value as 86,500 and putting this x value in our y equation. So what I'll get the total trips generated here. So here y is equal to 5.34 plus 0.40 into x, where x is 86,500. Here if I take it in 1000, then it is 86.5, because our all the values in x and the generated trips both are in thousands and hundreds respectively. So here in relation with x I will get 86.5 and this value is in thousands, that's why I have written here 86.5. By computing what I'll get, I'll get 39.94. these trips are in hundreds and ultimately our y value, because you have seen in our data that y value is in hundreds, so our answer is 3994 that trips are going to be generated in nearest future. So this is our simple example of linear regression analysis on zonal basis. Now we will move towards our second problem, and here the statement is: the following information was collected during the transportation survey of the study area. Develop the linear regression model for the estimating the trips generated from the zone. If the population of the particular zone may increase to 40,000, then predict the trips for that zone. Here in travel zone there are a number of 8 entries, so our n value is 8. Here the population in 1000 in given in x, that is our independent variable, and our dependent variable again it is futuristic trips or total trip generated in these particular zones. So these are in thousands again. Earlier it was in hundreds, here it is in thousands. Now as I said, our dependent variable y, that is total trip generated per zone, independent variable is x, that is population in each zone, and number of observation that we have taken, that is n, and that is 8 in value. Then our trip generating equation for linear regression analysis is y is equal to a plus px, where a and b are additive and multiplying constant respectively. So for computing all these required details, again I'll plot those values on tables. Okay, so we have number of zones, we have the value of x and y, that is total trips generated is y and total population in 1000, that is our x. Now what we require? We require xy value, x square value and y square value. Here by computing those value we have the answers. Now what do we require? We require the summation of all these things, and what I'll get here, sigma n is equal to 8, sigma x is equal to 214, sigma y is equal to 103.8, sigma x y is equal to 2839.12, x square is 5864.48, and sigma y square, what we have? We have 1388.6. Now you have to carefully calculate these values, and I'm carry forwarding these values so you can easily put those values in the desirable equation. So first of all we need to find out the x bar value, then y bar value, then b value, and I will find out the additive constant, and from that I will make the trip generating model for these constant. So first x bar is equal to sigma x upon n. Here the sigma x is 214 upon n, that is number of entry, that is 8 samples that we have taken, and the answer is 26.75. now second is the y bar value, that is sigma y upon n, and we have the sigma y value, that is 103.8 divided by 8, we'll get the answer, that is 12.975. Now we have the multiplying constant value, that is b value, and that equation is n sigma xi yi minus sigma xi into sigma yi upon n sigma xi square minus sigma xi whole square. By putting those required value, as you are used to with this term, so I'm just going through quickly. Here our answer is 0.446. That is our b value, that is multiplying constant. Now I will compute our additive constant, that is a value, and here we have the equation a is equal to y bar minus b into x bar, where I will put those computed values, that is x bar, y bar and the b value, and I will get the answer, that is 1.04. now having these values, that is a and b, I will make the trip generating equation in the form of y is equal to a plus bx, where y is dependent variable and the x is independent variable. Now what we have y is equal to 1.04 plus 0.446 into x, and that is our trip production equation. Now I will validate this equation in terms of coefficient of correlation, that is r value. By putting the value in this r equation, I will get the answer, and that is 0.816, which is more than 0.8, and hence there is a strong relationship between this independent and dependent variable. Now we have the futuristic population of the zone, that is 40,000, and by in terms of numbers or in terms of 1000, it is x is equal to 40 for use in this model. In this trip production equation, I will just put this value and find out the number of futuristic trips in the zone, and that is 1888 trips that is going to be generated in the future. So this is how you have to calculate the linear regression analysis example on those zonal basis. So what I have done here extra, and that is after validating this equation, I will make the given data, that is of futuristic population of zone, that value I will put into our trip production equation, that is in the form of y is equal to a plus bx, and by putting the value of x in the equation, I will get the futuristic trips that is going to be generated in the future, and that is our answer. So I am ending this session. I hope you have learned from this session. Thanks for watching this video.